ऑडिबल?
यस
यस सर,
सर।
वॉइस इज, या तो प्रीवियस
सर
क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट वोल्टेज कंट्रोल मेथड्स एंड आल्सो वी डिस्कस्ड करंट कंट्रोल मेथड्स, राइट? सो इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस सम अदर टॉपिक, सो दैट इज द डेड बैंड सर्क्यूट, and their effects on means how to create and how to create dead band circuits and their effect on output voltage, and we'll see the its compensation. This is all about today's lecture, right? So normally you're aware that in any phase lag, right, if any phase lag, the switches S1 and S4 are complementary. The switches S1 and S4 are complementary, right? So when S1 is on, so obviously or automatically we need to keep S4 off, right? So if both are simultaneously on, so what could be the resultant? The source is short circuited, right? The source is short circuited. A large current will flow in the circuit. Either these two switches, right, will carry large current. So therefore, these two switches will damage, and the entire inverter may damage. Right, the source may be damaged, or these two switches are damaged. Right. So practically, you might have studied in APC course. You might have studied in APC course, right? Right now, you might have studied these different switches, right? Okay. You studied the turn on time, T on, and T off. You studied this, right? So ideally, when the switch is normally switched on, right, what should be it's supposed to be turned on instantaneously, and its voltage is output voltage Vs. So this is the ideal case when the switch is on, right? But practically, what will happen? So in practical case, what will happen? It will take some time, right, and it will reach to this point, right? So this is normally known as T on, right, turn on time. So this is normally known as turn on time, right? So this consists of two time durations, right? What are those? What are those time delays? You might have
right,
studied,
time
right?
Time.
It is first delay time and rise time, okay? So delay time and rise time, okay? Similarly, in turn off, you have two times. So one is delay time and fall time. Clear? So this entire two will contribute to the switching losses or the switching time, that is on time. You have on, similarly you have turn off time, right? So normally these values are in micro, is less than microsecond. It may be in, it's in the order of 10 to the power of minus 7. It is normally in the order of 10 to the power of minus 7. In case of MOSFET, right, it is even lower. It is in the order of some nanoseconds. In case of MOSFET, it is in the order of nanoseconds, right? So that is all depends on the device constructions and how much switching frequency actually the device will allow, right? So this is practical thing, right? It's supposed to be take some time. Right. So ideally, we will discuss first ideal thing. So let us consider what we studied, that is sine PWM technique that we studied earlier. Right. This is sine PWM technique. So consider this is one carrier signal. So assume that it is one carrier period. Right. So assume that this is one carrier period. So out of so many carriers in one cycle, so assume that we are considering only one carrier. And this is modulating signal. Right. So normally, so ideally, if this is the carrier signal, right? So it is supposed to be something like this, right? So this is sine wave, right? Clear. So we assumed that. So instead of this waveform, right, so we assume that, so this waveform is something like this, Okay, in previous class we discussed this, right? Symmetrical sampling and asymmetrical sampling. So during this period, it's supposed to be a sine wave. It will supposed to follow a sine curve, but we assumed that so during this period or during this carrier period, so this is constant. Okay, so this is constant. The same thing here. It's supposed to be something like this, right? But we safely assume that so this is constant. Clear? So these are the switching intersecting points. This is intersecting point one, and this is the another intersecting point. So only one assumption is that, so instead of it is varying sinusoidally, we assume that so it is almost constant during that carrier period. Okay, so there is nothing to do that, because only it will dictate the intersecting points. So assume that this is switching S1, and this is opposite switch S4. Clear? So this is comparison. So this is one, and this is two, and this is three. So in one, right, in region one, the modulating signal is less than the carrier signal. So therefore, the switch is off. So this S1 is off. So during this period of time, the switch is on. So something like this, right? And the corresponding S4, right? So this is complementary to this one. So therefore, during this period, so it is high, and during this period, it is low, and subsequent period, in third mode, so it is high. Clear? So this is the pulses that ideally it generates. Clear? So if we consider for the same case, so when the conduction is something like this, so if you measure the pole voltage, right, if you measure the pole voltage, so how it will be? So voltage between A and zero when switch S4 conducts, pole voltage. Right, so what is VS0 when S4 conducts? So it is minus Vs by 2, right? So when S4 conducts, similarly, so Vs0 equal to plus Vs by 2 when S1 conducts, right? So this is when S1 conducts. So in this first region, so S4 is conducting, so therefore output voltage is negative. Output voltage is negative, right? So this is minus Vs by 2. So this is minus Vs by 2. And in the second one, so here S1 is conducting. So therefore we have this positive voltage. And again, you have this negative voltage. So this is plus Vs by 2. And you have this minus Vs by 2. So this is ideal case. Right. So this is ideal case. So practically, what will happen? So here, so this is rising edge, right? It is changing from minus Vs by 2 to plus Vs by 2. So you're not actually produce something like this. So you will get some delayed waveform, right? You'll get some delayed waveform. So here also you will get some delayed waveform. So usually I'm showing it a larger one. So usually this time duration is very, very small. It is in the order of 10 to the power of minus 7 seconds. Right. So here also, so when the pulse is rises, it will take its own time. So that means at some point of time, like during this point of time, so both switches S1 and S4 are conducting. So one switch S1 is trying to turn on, and at the same time S4 is trying to turn off. Right. So that means there should be some overlap period. So in that period, so both simultaneously on, and the source will be short circuited, right? To prevent that, so what we had to do is, so to prevent that, so what we had to do is, we need to wait for some time. We need to wait for some time. So when the switch, for example, S1 is turned on, right? For example, S1 is on. So we need to turn off this S1. So, right. So we need to turn off this one. So this S1 is turned off. So this is signal for S1. So this S1 is turned off. And so here at the same point, we need to turn on switch S4. So this is the point, so where we need to turn on S4, right? So therefore, what we have to do is we have to wait for some time, right? We have to wait for some time and we'll turn on this switch S4. Clear? So this is known as, so this delay time TD, right? So when the transition occurring from S1 to S4 or S4 to S1, right? So we will, so whatever the switch that is incoming switch, right? So we will wait for some time, right? Until the outgoing switch is completely turned off, right? And later we will give the firing signal to the incoming device and there will be safe transition from outgoing to incoming and incoming to outgoing, right? So that is the objective. So what we have to do is, so usually, this delay time is in the order of 1 microsecond or 2 microsecond at most, right? So this delay time is in the order of 1 microsecond or 2 microsecond. So whereas this turn off and turn off time, right? This turn on and turn off time, so is in the order of 10^-7, right? So we can almost negligible, right? So this turn on and turn off time, so it's almost, we will neglect this, right? We'll almost neglect this when compared to this delay time TD. So that means this TD is much higher than this T on or T off, right? So now what we have to do, see the switch S1. So these are the ideal transitions from S1 to S4 and S4 to S1, right? So now we have some delayed transition. So this is switch S1 and this is switch S4 with some time delay. So this is with some time delay. Clear? So here, this S1, right? So here it's trying to turn on, right? The switch is at this point, it's trying to turn on. So what we have to do is we'll provide some delay. So we will provide some delay. So something like this. So we will provide this much of delay to this waveform. Right. So when you want to turn off this one, so we will turn off immediately. So something like this. Okay. Right, so we are providing the delay, so when the device is turning on, but the turn off instant is same. So here, it's supposed to turn on here. So at this point, we are supposed to turn on, and at this point, it's supposed to turn off. So we'll provide this much of delay. So this delay is TD. So assume that, so this delay is TD. Similarly,
Excuse
on the other
me,
side,
sir.
Yes?
Sir, I didn't get that point, sir. How delay time is greater than turn on time or turn off time, sir?
No, we are providing this externally, right? Okay, this 1 microsecond or 2 microsecond, we are providing this externally, right?
Okay, sir. Okay,
see here, for example, this is the transition, ideal transition, okay? So this is the point, you know that, so this is the practical transition, okay? So this is the practical transition. Okay, this is the dangerous zone, right? Okay,
yes, sir.
This is the dangerous zone, but you are to safeguard that one. So you are taking extra measure, but you are making this. This is it should be the transition. Okay.
Yes, sir, yes. Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes.
So
sir,
this
yes,
is
sir.
TD, and this is actual T on. Okay. So why
yes,
we are
sir,
considering
yes,
this one is we are always drawing the sharp raising edge and sharp falling edges, right? Actually, it's supposed to be very like this, right? Because this T on and T off is very small and negligible. So therefore, so we are drawing some strike lines. Okay. So this
yes,
is the
sir,
danger
yes.
zone, right? Where the device is trying to turn on. Okay, this clear.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So this is how this delay time TD is provided for the switch S4. Similarly, come to this S4. Sorry, S4. So here this is the device is trying to turn off, and this is device is trying to turn on. Right. So that means when the device is trying to turn on, so draw it as it is. Okay. So draw it as it is. But when you are trying to turn on, so just provide some same amount of delay. It's clear? So provide the same amount of delay time. This is TD. Is clear? It's clear. So that means the raging edges are delayed. So this is raising edge, right? So this is delayed some TD time. So similarly for S4, the rising edge is delayed. So we have two edges, right? One is raising edge and falling edge. The pulse changes from 0 to 1. So that is raising edge. So it is raising, that is when the pulse is changing from 1 to 0. So that is falling edge. Clear? Right. So this how this time delay is provided. So now, so output will be, so what could be the change in the output voltage? So will it be same? So obviously this output voltage will change, right? So when the pulse pattern is changes, so obviously the output voltage will change. So now we will see, so where the difference will come, right? So from here up to this point, I'm marking here. So up to this point, is there any change? Up to this point, is there any change here? Is there any change? From this point, from here to here, so is there any change?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So there is no change. I will write in numbers, right? So say it is 1. So this is delay period, right? Okay. So here for at this point, from here to here, is there any change? So if you notice that, so from here, the S1 is off and S4 is also off, right? In the first time delay period, so in this region, so both S1 and S4, so both are off. Okay, so both switches S1 and S4 are off. So what should be the output voltage?
0.
0.
What should be the output voltage?
0, sir.
0.
So one thing, tell me one thing. So in this, right, so will you get 0 voltage? In pole voltage, will you get 0 voltage?
Vs by 2 or minus Vs by 2.
So it may be plus Vs by 2 or minus Vs by 2, right? So you have to notice that. So in this case, the switches S1 and S4, both are off, right? But at the same time, there is a possibility that the anti-parallel diode will conduct. Clear? Okay. So if the switches are off, that doesn't mean it's nothing is conducting, right? So obviously to maintain the current in the same direction, right, to maintain the current in the same direction, so obviously this anti-parallel diode will conduct, right? Okay. So during this period of time, so this diode will conduct. Okay. Yes. So if the diodes are conduct, you may get positive voltage or negative voltage. So that all depends on the current direction. So when the diode will conduct, so when there is a positive voltage or negative voltage, that depends on the current direction, right? So that means, so from here to here, right? So that means during this interval, from here to here, so that all depends on the current direction, right? And which device is in conduction, right? So which diode is in conduction? Right, so based on that, the output voltage may be positive or it may be negative, right? So based on that, the output voltage may be positive or it may be negative. So similarly here, right, so during this region, after once this delay time is on, so during this region, so which is conducting, so it is same as it is, right? So therefore, the plus Vs by 2 is retained. So plus Vs by 2 is retained. So if you come to here, so again, So during this delay time, again this delay time, so we are supposed to conduct, in this period, we are supposed to conduct
diode.
So again, both switches are off, right? So that all depends on the current direction and which device or which diode is in conduction, right? So that means it may be something like this. So it may be stop somewhere here, it is follow as it is, or it may be follow this pattern. Okay, so during this period, or in second delay period, if the output voltage, right, if it is negative, so you will get same minus Vs by 2. So that means up to this point you will get say minus Vs by 2, or you may get plus Vs by 2. So during this period, so once this delay time is over, so again the switch S4 is off on, so therefore you will get the negative voltage on the pole voltage. Clear? Is clear? Right, so we have successfully provided the delay between the devices. We have successfully provided delay between the devices. So normally there is no change in the operation, except that during the turn on, means during the delay period, so where we are providing some external delay, so that is only causing the disturbance in the operation. So rest of the operation is remain same, right? Okay, so now we have to find out, so what could be the operation during that delay period. So when the current is positive, so what could be the waveform, and the current is negative, so what could be the waveform that we need to identify. Clear? So our next activity is that, so before that, so we'll see how to provide the time delay. So externally, how to provide the time delay, right? So simple thing, right? So you have something, the pulse is something like this. Okay, so you are aware that this RC circuits normally provide some time delay, right? RC circuits, that is first order circuits, you might have studied in circuit theory, right? So for example, if you give some voltage, if the circuit is something like this, you are all studied the response of these switches, right? Okay, it will be provide some delay circuit, something like this, right? So this is the point where the switch is on, this is the voltage across capacitor. You have studied this, right? So once the capacitor reaches to the steady state voltage, that is Vs, right? So this charging current will become zero, and the capacitor charged to full source voltage. You have studied this, right? Okay, so when you have only R in the circuit, when you have resistor in the circuit, so when you have resistor in the circuit, so the circuit will be something like this, right? When you have only resistor in the circuit. So if you introduce this capacitor in series with the resistor, so the output voltage will be slightly delayed, right? So how much that time is delayed, you're all aware of time constant and other things, right? Okay, so time constant is RC, right? So practically from here to here, it will reach RC time. Okay, clear? You are aware of these basics, right? The same concept I'm using here to provide the time delay. Okay, so this is the actual pulse here, right? This is the actual pulse here. I want to provide some time delay. I want to provide some time delay to this. So what I do is, I just connected an RC circuit here, so therefore the waveform is rises like this. Agree? Okay, so this is the actual waveform, right? So this is waveform with RC circuit, the same waveform with RC circuit. So the waveform is rises like this, right? Similarly, right, so during fall time, right, so it's supposed to discharge with this capacitor. So therefore, there is a change in the fall time also, right? Then when the capacitor is discharged. This is clear? But in our actual solution, so we have to provide only time delay during the on time. When the device changing from off state to on state, so then only we need to provide the time delay. So now this is required, right? But this is not required. It's supposed to be not change the transition when it is changing, means when the switch is changing from off state to on state. So this is not required, right? So what we have to do is, right? So what we have to do is, our original waveform is something like this. So the waveform, so that what actually you're obtained is something like this. Okay, the waveform that actually you are obtained, this is original waveform and this is with RC circuit, but what you want, right? So there should be small delay in this one, and again, so it's the trailing end or this falling edge should be as it is. Okay, it should be as it is. So which logic gate is required for this? So which logic gate what is required for this? AND gate is required, right? So okay, AND gate is required here. So the same thing I done here. So this is the original signal, right? So this is the original signal. So this original signal is passing to the AND gate. So this original signal is passing to the AND gate, and the other signal is provided with some time delay, right? So time delay, and after that I have given to these two NOT gates. We'll come back to this one, right? So assume that these two NOT gates are presented for time being, right? So I'm given this. This is at this point it will give you a delayed signal, right? Okay, so this is what the actual operation. So it in from this you will get this output, right? So whichever is common to that, so that is obtained at this point. Clear? This clear? So now why I used these two AND gates? Is there any wrong with this one? Is there any, it will change any, means whether it will change this one? For example, this is one here, right? So this will become zero here, and again this will become one here, right? Okay, connecting two NOT gates will not alter the output voltage. We have truth tables, right? From truth tables wise, it will not provide any modification to the output voltage, because again NOT gate and again connecting another NOT gate, so that means same waveform will remain, right? But there is an advantage with this one, right? Because of this RC circuit, because if RC circuits, so normally we expect that a sharp rising and sharp, this is sharp rising pulse, right? This pulse is sharp rising pulse. So but whereas this pulse is not a sharp rising edge pulse, right? So normally all these electronic circuits, whenever we require some sharp rising or sharp falling edge circuits, so now we use these two NOT gates in series, right? We normally connect two NOT gates in series. So this is used to produce sharp rising edge. It will use it to provide sharp rising edge. Okay, is clear? It is simple, right? Normally ICs, all these ICs, right, NOT gate and all, right, integrated circuits, right? So they're designed to operate at 5 volts. They're designed to operate at 5 volts, but they start working from 3.3 volts. But they start working from 3.3 volts onwards, right? So by using this double NOT gates, so we can make this to operate at 5 volts, right? So this is normally used in CMOS, all these embedded circuits are this, right? You might have studied this in electronic course, okay? Just remember that, I don't want to go deep into that. So whenever we are using two NOT gates, so that means the purpose is that in electron circuits to provide sharp rising edge signals. Clear? Right, so we need to provide this one. This is for S1, and similarly this is to provide for S4. Clear? This is for S1 and this is for S4. Is clear?
Yes,
Have
sir.
Any doubts on this? Okay, so now if you notice that this resistor is 1K and this capacitor is 0.001 microfarad, this capacitor is 0.001 microfarad, right? So you have this time constant. What is the time constant here?
1 microsecond.
What is time constant?
1 microsecond.
1K into 0.001, right? So that is 1 microsecond, right? Okay. So that means this circuit will provide an exact 1 microsecond delay, right? This circuit will provide a 1 microsecond delay. If you want 2 microsecond delay, so what we have to do is you just change it to 2K. So if you connect a 2K resistor, so here, okay, if you connect a 2K resistor, so now the time means now the delay time is changed to 2 microseconds. Okay, clear. Since why I used this 1K and this, right, these are all small circuits, right? These are designed for 5 volts, so therefore we have to use kilo ohm resistors. Okay, because the circuit is small, so we have to use the small value of resistors to limit the current. Okay, clear. So don't think that we can use 1 ohm resistor and 10 to the power of minus 6, that is 1 microfarad capacitor. Okay, you can also select 1 ohm resistor and 1 microfarad capacitor. But the, what is the problem with 1 ohm resistor? If you connect in series with 1 ohm resistor, right? So there will be a huge drop in the resistor. Means the current will be high in the circuit, right? Okay, it will draw large current. So to avoid that one, so we normally reduce the size of resistor. Clear? Is clear? So this is the same thing.
No, sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, tau is equal to RC is the delay time you told. Shouldn't it be 5 times of it?
Mm-hmm.
Shouldn't it be 5 times RC to reach the steady state?
Not required, right? So that's why I told you, right, the processor start tweaking from 3.3 volts onwards, right?
Okay.
Okay. So that is enough, right?
Okay. Another one doubt is, instead of NOT gates, can we use buffer?
Yeah, you can use buffer also, right?
Okay. Okay.
This is the problem when you are using buffer, right? So this is NOT gate, right? Oh, so this is AND gate, and this is AND gate, right? So buffer, you have to use another kind of device, another kind of IC. For NOT gate, you have to use another kind of IC. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. The supply voltages may be changes, right? Clear. So normally we prefer this NOT gate because to maintain all the things in. So this is S1. I think this is S1. The bottom one is S1. Okay, maybe this is corresponding to S4 when you provide sufficient delay, right? So these are the waveforms actually obtained from. So if you notice that, so this delay period is exactly 1 microsecond, right? This delay period is 1 microsecond. So you have given, right? So this is 10 microsecond, right? This is 10 microsecond. So this from here to here, so it is 10 microseconds. So this is 10 microsecond period, right? So that means this delay may be 1 microsecond or 2 microsecond maybe, okay? Clear? So this is complementary pulses for S1 and S4. Okay, if you notice that, so we can observe this sharp rising edge pulses with double NOT gates, okay? We can obtain this sharp rising edge pulses with the double NOT gates. Okay, this is how to provide a time delay. So this is how to provide a time delay experimentally. If you are using some controllers, so externally you can use, right? So nowadays, right? So nowadays, these IGBTs, you might have studied in APC course. So IGBTs comes under with different packages, right? Earlier, maybe in 10 years back or 7 years back, so you will get only one device, so that is IGBT with some anti-parallel diode. Okay, So that is IGBT with anti-parallel diodes. So usually get the device. So it may be normally rated at 1000 volts or 1.2K or 2.3K or at most now 4.3K or 4.6K, I think. 4.6K or these devices are available. So now several manufacturers, what they do, right? So the when you're connecting these two devices in a series to form a one-phase leg, so now manufacturers are come up with one, right? So this entire phase leg, right, they're producing one phase leg. So in same fabric or same die, so they have three legs. So this is cathodes and this is anode, right? And this middle one is this A phase, clear? So that means instead of manufacture individual devices, that is a device with a diode, so that they're directly manufacturing one phase leg. Right, so those are known as semi-pack. Right, so those are known as semi-pack. And even some manufacturers are directly producing this H-bridge on a single die. Okay, they're directly producing H-bridge or two-level inverter on a single die. That means entire bridge, that means in a single, so you have three terminals, right? And middle three terminals are available. Okay, so these upper ones are anodes and these bottom ones are cathodes and the middle ones are for the connection of phase circuit and you need to connect externally to the DC source by using this anode and cathode, right? Clear? So that is normally this why this is providing this one, right? So this inherently inside this one, so automatically some time delay is provided. So this is normally to avoid short circuit. Okay, so this is about the dead band circuits and how its affect. So now we move forward to that actual discussion. Right, so this is what we discussed, right? So this is switching signal corresponding to S1 and this is corresponding to S4. So these are the ideal transitions. So this is the ideal transitions. And these are the delayed transitions. I hope this is correct. Okay, this is S1, so it's a delayed transition. So this is S4, some delayed transition. Clear? So now our objective is to draw the output voltage. So corresponding to, so assume that the current is positive. Okay. So positive current means, so we'll come to this one, right? So assume that the current direction is like this, okay? So assume that the current direction is like this. Okay, now the question is, so which device are in conduction? Assume this is D1 and this is D2, so D4. Okay, the load current is positive. The inverter current is positive. So which device will normally conduct?
D4.
So here the current will flow like this, right? Okay. And another one, the current will flow like this because the switch S4 is not conduct in the opposite direction, right? So actually what device in the current is positive, right? So this is positive. So which device are in conduction? S1 and D4 are in conduction, right? So S1 and D4 are in conduction. Similarly, when the current is positive, S1 and D4 are in conduction. Similarly, when the current is negative, so which device are in conduction? So current is negative. So I will draw here, for example, right? So in this case, the current is going inside the inverter. So which device are in conduction? So this top diode will conduct and this bottom transistor will conduct, right? Okay. This top diode and the bottom transistor will conduct. So therefore here S4 and D1 will conduct. Is clear? Is it clear? So we have two options when the positive current is positive, either S1 will conduct or the diode D4 will conduct. So when the current is negative, S4 and D1 will conduct. Clear? So we'll move to this one. Okay. So now I assume that the current is positive. Right. So I will draw the actual output voltage. So this is the actual output voltage, right? So this is the actual output voltage. Okay. So now tell me, so which device are conducting here? Which device is conducting here? So here, which device is conducting?
S4 and D1.
S4 and D1.
S4 and D1, right? Okay. So, but practically, which device is in conduction? Practically, which device is in conduction?
S4.
S4.
So I said that the current is positive, right? Okay. So current is positive, but the S4 will not allow the current in the opposite direction, right? Okay. Actual current flow is in the which device? Actual current flow is in which device? That's my question.
S1.
So you're not understanding that.
Yes, S4 should be there.
Okay. See here, the first one, right? Do not mix up that positive current. So when you have positive current, so these two, right? So when you have positive current, so either S1 will conduct or D4 will conduct. Okay. Right. So when you have negative current, either S4 will conduct or D1 will conduct. Right. So now, right, output voltage is negative. Output voltage is negative, but the output voltage is negative, and the output current is also negative. So output current is positive. So which device is conducting? So this D4, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Same thing when the output is positive. Again, the current is negative. So here this D4 is conducting. So here, which device is conducting? So output current is also positive. So which device is in conduction?
This one,
right. So here, S1 will conduct, right? So here, S4 and D1 will not come into the picture, right? Because the current is positive. S4 and D1 will not come into the picture. So only S1 and D4 will contribute to the load voltage and load current. Okay. So now, so which device is conducting here? So this is D4. Okay. D4. So in this case, switch S1 is on, right? So therefore, you have S1 and again you have D4. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. So, right. Okay, now, so this is what it's supposed to be, right? Okay, now this is ideal, right? Yeah. So now come to this area. This area. So both devices are off, right? So both devices are off. S1 and S4 are off, right? Both devices are off. So during this period, so which device is likely to likely to be conduct?
Diode.
D4, sir.
Right. So which device is likely to be conduct here now? To maintain the... See here, the current is positive. The current is positive. Okay, up to this point, this diode D4 is conducting. From here, diode D4 is conducting. So at this point, so both switches are off. Okay, so what should happen now? Right, so here this is inductive current, right? So you cannot interrupt the current improperly, right? So what will happen? So this diode D4 will continue to conduct, right? This diode D4 will continue to conduct until the switch S1 is turned on. Okay, this diode D4 will continue to conduct until the switch S1 is turned on. This is clear?
Yes,
is clear?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Right, because it is inductive current, right? You cannot directly bring the current to zero, right? So therefore, the diode is continuing to conduct so until the switch S1 is turned on, right? Okay. So here it is continuing the same thing. See, it is continuing the same thing because both S1 and S4 are turned on. So that means the current is only through S1. So now at this point, the second delay period, so that is during the second interval. So this second delay interval, right? So what should supposed to happen? Right? So now S1 is turned off, right? Okay. So S1 is turned off, right? Agree? Clear? So S1 is turned off. So now the current is transferred from S1 to D4, right? The current is transferred from S1 to D4. So that means, so directly this current is like this. It's clear? You might have known this, right? The transferring of the current from one switch to other switch. I think this is simple example. So you have, this is what commonly studied example of transfer of current from one switch to other switch. Okay, so assume that, so this is S1 for our study and this is diode D4. Okay, so this is inductive load. Okay, this is inductive load, right? So when the switch when this S1 is on, right, what will happen? So the current will flow like this, right? So this, since this diode is for, means this diode is reverse biased, right? So this is, you know, the concept of freewheeling diode, right? So how the current is transferred from, so the main diode to freewheeling diode and freewheeling diode to main diode. So when main thyristor or main diode is in reverse bias, so when this S1 or then when this is in reverse bias, the current is transferred from S1 to D4, and when it is forward bias, the current is transferred from D4 to S1. The same concept here. Okay, see here also, when this main, this is S1 is off, right? So automatically the current is transferred to, when S1 is off because of this reverse bias, the current is transferred to this D4. So that means a current will flow like this, right? So current flow in this direction, right? Because to maintain the current in the same direction, right? You know this concept, right? The concept of freewheeling diode. The same thing here. So here, right, when both switches are off, the diode is carrying the current. So when the switch is off, when switch S1 is off, again the current is transferred to this diode D4. Is clear? Is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. So that means one thing we can notice, that so when the current is positive, there is a change here, but there is no change here. Okay, so this blue one is the ideal, means the blue one, the red one are the ideal waveforms, and this blue one is the actual waveform, right? So here there is no change in the when there is transition there, here there is no change here, but there is a change at this point, right? So what is the voltage, right? What is it supposed to be? Something like this, right? So it's supposed to be something like this. So what is the voltage lost here? So this much voltage is lost, right? So how much voltage? So this much voltage is lost here, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
This much voltage is lost, right? Okay, if I draw only that last pulse, so here, right, so that is difference between the ideal one and the actual one. The difference between the ideal one and the actual one. So how it will be? The difference between the ideal one and the actual one. Right, so it will be something like this, right? Agree? You agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
It's zero. So what is the magnitude? What is the peak value here?
VDS by 2.
What is VS that value?
VS by 2.
Here this is VS by 2, right? And this is VS minus VS by 2. This is minus VS by 2.
Minus VS.
And this is minus VS by 2 and minus VS by 2, right? So this value is VS, right? Agree? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Clear. So this much of voltage we lost, right? And this time delay is TD. So that means we lost TD into VS volt seconds. We lost TD into VS volt seconds, right? We lost this much of energy, right? That is TD into VS. This delay time is TD and its peak magnitude is VS. So that much is we lost. Clear? This is for positive current. So we'll quickly compute the negative current. I will redraw quickly. This is for S1. This is for S4. S1 delayed. S4 delayed. Right. So I will draw the actual output. So this is actual output, ideal. Okay. So now I will divide into three parts again. This is 1, 2. And this is 3, right? So during 1, which device is in conduction?
S4. Four.
So during 1, so which D4. Device is in conduction?
D4.
S4.
D4.
D4, sir.
Yes,
4. Negative, load current is negative.
S4.
D4. We already discussed that when you have negative, so which device are supposed to turn on?
D1.
D1 and?
S4.
S4, right? S4. So here, which device is in conduction now?
S4.
S4. S4, right?
S4, sir.
So here? D1 and here it is S4, right? Is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is clear. Is clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Yes. Okay, now we'll draw these practical waveforms.
sir wonder
sir in this sir voltage is negative na
so
whenever voltage is negative only right and current is also negative
I'm not understand your question
okay sir okay I've got it
voltage is negative it's toggling from negative to positive right or positive to negative
okay
no sir another right? doubt sir
yeah
sir how you decided current is negative or positive in previous example you said
no we have two options right we are analyzing the circuit right okay we are analyzing the effect of current is positive or negative okay in one case we assume that the inverter is feeding the load okay and another case we assume that the load is feeding the inverter right
okay sir understood okay
so this is our assumption only right so inverter will do the you know the tried basic thing ac to dc conversion it will also do dc to ac conversion right okay the current may be positive or negative right so here the simple thing right so if you assume this is the output of inverter okay if you assume that so this is the output of inverter so assume that it is a sinusoidal right so also assume that the current so inverter current so that is also ac current right so this is another sinusoidal right clear so this is another sinusoidal so here this inverter current is positive so whereas here the inverter current is negative is clear is clear
yes sir clear
okay so every interval of cycle the inverter changes current direction changes right okay so now right now come to here what should be the voltage difference of these two so here up to here so there is no change in the output voltage so up to here so there is no change in the output voltage so now right so now what will happen during this first delay period what will happen during this first delay period so both s1 and s4 are off right both s1 and s4 are off and ideally d1 should conduct right ideally d1 should conduct so d1 should conduct right so that means so both are off right therefore the current is transferred from the switch s4 to d1 the switch s4 to d1 clear so it will continue up to this point it will continue up to this point so during second delay time what will happen so during second delay time s1 and s4 both are turned off right so this is a diode is conducting right thus now diode is conducting right so both switches are off so therefore you cannot transfer the current to s4 you cannot transfer the current to s4 so it will wait until the s4 is turned on so it will wait until the s4 is turned on right so this is the point where s4 is turned on right so therefore this is the output voltage clear is clear
yes sir
yes sir
okay so now what is the difference between the ideal and so this is ideal voltage and the practical voltage so what is the difference so this is the one right so this is the extra voltage that you obtained right okay so it's supposed to be something like this but this some you got some extra voltage right so here there is no change here so here there is some change in output voltage transition so you got some change in the output voltage transition clear clear
yes sir
okay
yes sir
so now I will draw the error voltage right or the difference voltage right so up to this there is no change right so both ideal and both are same right so there is no change here so that is zero so here you got some positive pulse right you got this much of positive voltage. And again, there is no change, right? So what is its magnitude is Vs. Okay, so this is difference between Vs0 ideal minus Vs0 practical. Is clear? Is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you summarize this positive current and the negative current, in positive current, the error is negative. So that means the actual output voltage is reduced, right? In case of negative, right? In case of negative current, the actual output voltage is slightly increased, right? So here also the increase is Vd into Td, so voltage seconds. Clear? Is clear? So remember all these during one carrier interval, right? So all this happening during one carrier interval. So if you have several carrier intervals, right? If you have several carrier intervals, for example, if this is the direction of current, so if you assume this is the direction of output current, right? This is the output direction current voltage error. When the current is positive, the error is negative, right? The current is positive, the error is negative. So you have some error here. So this is corresponding to one carrier period. So this is corresponding to another carrier period. So something like this. Again, in the negative half cycle, the error is positive. Is clear? So its magnitude is minus Vs, and it's here its magnitude is plus Vs, and this delay time is Td. Is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So all this analysis, what we've done is for change in one carrier, right? So this is the fundamental thing, right? So this is one carrier, this corresponding to one carrier, so interaction of modulating signal, so we are represented here. Clear? So output voltage gain, so in case of positive, see, simple summarize, so output voltage is reduced when the current is positive, output voltage is increased slightly when the current is negative. It's clear? Right. So this entire thing is the error voltage, right? So this is the error graph. So there is just some average value to this one, right? Because all this is equal magnitude. So that means we can adjust. So there will be some average value for this. So this average value may be something like this. So if we assume that, so this is Ts period, right? So this is time period Ts, right? So what is the average value of this one? Can anyone tell? What is the average of this waveform?
Zero.
It won't be zero, no? AC waveforms, we need to calculate for off cycle. We need to calculate for half cycle, right? Simply, what is the average value of this one? Sine wave average is zero.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
It's not zero, right? It is having some average value, right? If it is a square wave, what is its average value? What is the average value of square wave? So it is equal to its magnitude, right? Average value and RMS value, both are same, right? Can't be simply zero. So we need to take it for half cycle. When it is quarter wave symmetry, so then its value is zero. Okay. So now, what is its average value? So you have, so you can easily find out its average value. So here this output voltage is VDC, right? And its time is TD. So here, so this is there for every half cycle, right? So therefore, it is VDC by 2 times TS. So this is its average value. Okay. Right. So here, ultimately, so here this voltage error is produced a, the voltage error is produced a square waveform. It produced a square waveform. Right. Its magnitude, this is V error. Okay. So when you have square waveform, right, so obviously you have certain harmonics, that is third order harmonic, fifth, seventh, ninth, and so on. So that's what we discussed, right? But in line voltage, this third and ninth order harmonics are eliminated in line. Okay, so in line voltage, this third and seventh order harmonic is eliminated. So third and ninth order harmonic is eliminated. So you left with fifth order harmonic and seventh order harmonic and some fundamental. Right. So now we'll conclude this. So what is the disadvantage with deadband circuit? So with deadband circuit, the output voltage changes, right, changes depending on current direction. Depending on the current direction, and it will induce some lower order harmonics. It will induce some lower order harmonics, right? So just think that, so this is of small magnitude of 2 to 3 volts. It is a small magnitude of 2 to 3 volts, right? So compared to your 230 volt signal, so it is a small magnitude, right? So if we assume that, so this is actual modulating signal, right? Or this actual output voltage, and this is your current waveform. And this is your current waveform. I'll draw it in another color. So this is your current waveform, right? If this is the voltage waveform, right? The corresponding, the error voltage, if the current, this is current, right? The corresponding error voltage will be something like this. Okay, so this is the summation of all small pulses or the errors of all, right? And that we, what we discussed, right? So this is the average of all. Is clear? So this is the average of all signals. So all pulses, what we lost. Similarly, this is negative. Okay, so this is the actual output voltage and this is the error voltage. So this is ideal output voltage and this is the error voltage. So what should be the actual voltage? So the difference between this ideal voltage and this error voltage, right? So that is the one, it is something like this. Okay, so this is ideal voltage and this is corresponding current and this corresponding the error signal will be something like this. So if a negative, it is minus. I think I'd wrongly drawn here. So if it is negative, so here if it is negative, you have negative error. and this is positive error. You can just change it. Okay. It's clear. So this is the summation of all pulses, right? So these are the errors of all pulses of with TD, and this is its average value, and this is the actual output voltage, right? The dotted one is the actual output voltage. Clear? This clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So normally, so this error is 1 to 2%. So normally, this error is 1 to 2%. This error is normally 1 to 2%. Right. So here, this error can be compensated. This error can be compensated. Right. So here, when you want some high precision, so you're supposed to maintain the same amount of voltage. Right. For example, if the machine is exactly required 230 volts, you're supposed to produce that 230 volts exactly, right? So with the deadband circuits, that voltage may be somewhat slightly increased or decreased, right? For example, in positive off cycle, so for example, this is the ideal voltage is supposed to produce, right? But actually it is produced this much of voltage, right? Similarly, it is producing this much of voltage, right? But the output voltage is slightly lost, right? Same thing here also, the output voltage is changes, right? So this is not required if you want some high precision. So therefore, you can compensate this one by adjusting this in the modulation scheme. So how to adjust that? So this is the one. So assume this is motor. We are connected some motor drive. So here we are measuring the current, right? So here we are measuring the inverter current. So here we are measuring the inverter current, and this is the actual modulating signal, right? So this is the actual modulating signal, and this one, right? So this one, so we know the error, right? We can estimate the error by using the formula Vs into, that means Vs into TD by 2TS. Right, so this is the error voltage, right? We can calculate the average value of this square wave. So that is the error, right? So here, this depending on this current direction, so depending on the current direction, so this error is either added or subtracted from the actual modulating signal, right? So this error is added or subtracted from the actual modulating signal. The logic is simple, right? So here, you know the difference between these two, okay? You know the difference between the ideal and actual waveform, right? And this difference, either we need to add it to make it ideal, right? Or we need to subtract it, right? Either it is different, we need to add, or we need to separate. So that all depends on the current direction. So therefore, so we need to measure the current, right? Depending on the current direction, either we need to add to compensate that error voltage, or we need to subtract to compensate that error voltage, right? So rest of the things is PWM, that is sine PWM or any PWM. And this is your dead time logic, right? So this pulse is given with 1 microsecond delay, for example. This other pulse is given with some 1 microsecond delay. It's clear? You know the difference voltage between the actual and you know the error voltage, right? So that error voltage, if it is reducing, you just add it, okay, to compensate that, right? So here this error is depending on the current direction. So therefore, you need to measure the current direction or measure the current polarity. So based on the polarity, you need to add. It's clear? It's clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is how to compensate the dead time. If you have any doubts, you can ask now.
Sir?
Yeah.
Can you explain how we got the equation for average error voltage?
That is normal equation, right? 1 by, it is time 2TS. So that is off cycle, right? It is there for every off cycle, right? Okay. We need to consider off of the time period. Into its time period is TS, right? Into its value is VD into TD. This simple average method, right? It's average of one pulse.
Okay, sir.
Okay. This is how we will take average value, right?
Yes, sir.
So here we need to multiply with how many carriers are there? So we need to multiply with MF. So MF, that is how many pulses are there, right? So that is MF is FCR by this frequency modulation legs. So that means that will give the number of pulses. Okay, this one. So here each carrier will produce one pulse, right? So that means you have ultimately MF number of pulses, right? You have ultimately MF number of pulses. Clear?
Yes, sir.
You have any doubts on this?
No, sir.
If you have any doubts, you can ask now. Okay. Can I close the video?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Bye.
Okay, thank you, sir.
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 Thank you, sir.